Welcome to Highland Park High School as TSB Television proudly presents high school girls basketball. Today, a St. Paul City Conference match, a very close rivalry, should be a lot of fun as the Highland Park Scots host the Humboldt Hawks. Hello everyone, I'm Mike Peden, thank you for watching. These two schools have been very close over the last few years, a lot of single digit games, and even the game we covered last year was no slouch. Humboldt led by double digits in the first half of our game here, and then Highland Park came back to win by 12 points afterward. So, very up in the air, very close game, as these two schools have been fighting back and forth throughout the years as they battle for that St. Paul City Conference title. Humboldt, new identity this year for the first time in what seems like decades, no Hicks sisters on the roster. They've all graduated or left. Stepping up, though, is Lashay Holt, the junior forward. Has only played organized basketball since eighth grade, but you wouldn't know it looking at her stats. 20 points per game, 17 rebounds per game, leading the state in rebounds, also in the top 10 in steals. And it's not uncommon for her to get 20 and 20 per game. Highland Park doesn't have a strong go-to threat inside. They do have Kionda Nicks, although she has struggled in the last few games as Richfield and Prairie Seats Academy focused their defense on her at the Richfield Holiday Classic, although she came up big in a win over Harding. Erica Turner leading the team in scoring. For Highland Park, it's going to be key at getting themselves set up for postseason play. They've had some decent games against teams in their section, including Hill Murray and Tartan, but they could not close out. It's something they'll look to improve on as the season progresses. Keys to the game for Humboldt: it's all about ball control, scrappy, getting after those loose balls because they do not have a big roster, nobody above 5'11". And they want to optimize aggression, which is how Lashay Holt has put up such big numbers this season. Keys to the game for Highland: it's about transition baskets, playing solid defense as well. Again, they're not the strongest of teams, so they have to make sure they limit Humboldt's possessions. And getting those extra passes, just being patient on the offense because you have a hungry Lashay Holt waiting on defense. And if you take a bad shot, she could either strip it away or get the rebound and set up a transition bucket. Our tip-off is coming up in a moment. You're watching High School Girls Basketball.
Thank you. Yeah! Number 15, the last one. Substitution of the four silver mask school for Kenneth on Highland Park.
Second verse 16 time. some real background and Asha Crenshaw in the lineup for Highland Park.
TSB Television continues its coverage of high school girls basketball. We have a St. Paul City Conference game between the Highland Park Scots and the Humboldt Hawks. We have given the opportunity here for some stats leading the way. Lashay Holt for 10 points. Right now, he's a double-double over here. For rebounds. And then Daniel Hernandez at 7 on those sheets. Yeah.
Okay. I want to send them to play Central.
What's their good thing?
Colts. I want to see them play Central. Then the Central go
with them. Yeah, they're going to be
next week.
Are they doing all right there?
Central's always
good.
Yeah, they do. Yeah, and then if they can't go to Central, they come here. This is like option number two for most of them.
Yeah, I know, but that'll be interesting to see how they're playing next year when they start that zone in with the actual district areas.
Oh, they're busing, next year?
Yeah, so I don't know if that's how I'm going to fix them. I mean, it's kind of bullshit because they left up so many, so many holes because if you're one of the IB students, you get free buses.
Yeah.
And then if you're on the Spanish version, you get free buses.
Spanish version?
You know, it's like, whatever. And if both of those programs are huge, I don't know if they got the same shit up. I don't know how that's going to work.
Essentially, it's like, you said it was starting a game thing, so
I don't know how it's going to work.
Substitution number 25, Selena Steele, and the first round of Humboldt is placed on test field.
And, you know, just on the north or south side of McAllister. And the parents, man, we've always went to Highland or whatever. So, like, those kids on the north side of St. Clair are supposed to go to the south. I don't know how that's
going to
work. I think, Seal, we got his tissue ringing on that one. I don't know how that's going to work. But it'll be a big one.
That's a league issue.
30 seconds.
artistry on those Stillwater. Rose has an eighth grader on the team. Tartan has an eighth grader player. So, I mean, those suburban schools will let them do that. I don't know why. And the city schools won't let them do that.
Yeah, I don't know. That's kind of messed up. That's what it is.
These conferences have their own huge regulations.
That's probably what the high school needs to step in and say, hey, you know, this is straight across the board. I mean, they're trying to keep it even. Yeah. Well, I mean, that's like you say, like, he was selling out. You know, that's just like a school team over there. Yeah, okay, well, we'll give you some scholarship money.
Okay, well, look at Stillwater. Look at right there. They got good players. They go far in perception. That's because that's the only school they go to out there.
They go out there. They got a huge people to draw from.
Forest Lake's another school. Forest Lake, they always do it.
Yeah.
But they think it's such a good program out there. Lakeview has another school.
Well, you know,
they
didn't get into
collection
economics.
Yeah, like the facilities and the program,
well,
the summer program and stuff.
Okay, you know, like the whole junior high game is a title one. I mean, that's all my people are coming out for. My sister is in Orlando and mom's in Daytona.
So. I was working Fort Lauderdale. I went to college in Tennessee.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Our first one was four silver grand steward.
But it was the same, you know.
14, Marissa Franco shoots two.
I spent one summer on the that ain't no place for a fat guy like me, believe me when I tell you that.
Yeah, I don't like
that. You know, that's on Ocean Side, and it's cooler down there, so, you know, it's like, it was just burning up for me, man.
Stay up, stay up.
Verdict returns for Highland Park, replacing Tasha Crenshaw.
Thank you.
Substitution for Humboldt, Clark and Hernandez return. Clark's going into the shooter.
Humboldt.
one more reminder that we have the boys meeting Friday night at the Great Hosting and Aston High School, 7 o'clock in your early.
Thank you.
second personal, number 13, Castillo, 16 final, Humboldt.
Thank you.
I'm here with Kionda Nicks from Highland Park. You had a big game tonight, and over the years you've had a lot of success with Humboldt. Describe this battle tonight.
You know, it got a little scrappy at the end, but we got it in the end.
Now, from what I understand, you just became Highland Park's all-time leading scorer, from what I heard in the announcement.
Oh, I didn't even know.
You don't know. Well, you've been quite a force inside for the Scots all season as they moved to a 7-3 record. You struggled a bit at the Richfield tournament and really turned it on tonight. What did you learn from that tournament with opponents gunning for you?
Just be more aggressive, get in there, work hard.
So how are you using this season to prepare for your collegiate career over at Concordia St. Paul?
I'm expanding my range, trying to, you know, shoot a little bit more, open up my game.
And talk about the core for Highland. A lot of players came back this year, a lot of experience on this team, and how is that helping the Scots in their run and hopefully maybe even make some noise in the section that has eluded them for so long?
We got a lot of talent, a lot of seniors, so you know, we all work together. We've been working together for a couple years now, so we're good.
One of the keys that I talked about with one of your coaches was transition, and that's where Highland really was strong tonight. So how have you emphasized getting those fast break baskets and just getting the pressure on?
I just try and rebound and look up for my point guard sprinting to the cup, so that's it.
Well, still a long way to go, of course, in the St. Paul City Conference. St. Paul Central, another strong team this year. So how does this win set you up, a convincing one after a lot of back and forth battles between Humboldt over the last few years?
We're not going to relax. We're going to go practice hard and get ready for Central, get ready for the rest of our games.
Anyone you want to say hi to?
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Shout out to Erica, my co-captain. She's injured.
And she was the leading scorer before then, and you've stepped up nicely. A big game for you tonight. Congratulations, and we might see you down the road, maybe in sections, maybe even state, if things work out.
All right, thanks.